Good evening, everyone. I want to talk about a topic that has been coming up a lot in my courses and tutoring in the last couple weeks, and that is creating boundaries with family members and loved ones during your California bar exam preparation. This can also apply to law school or really any setting in your life where you are having distractions from family members or loved ones while you are trying to study or work or be in law school, etc., etc. So the first thing that you want to realize is that people that are trying to ask you on a consistent basis how your studying is going, maybe they're calling you a lot, texting you a lot, they're really just trying to show you support. They love you and they care about you. Maybe you haven't passed before and they're worried that that's going to happen again. I can tell you as a mother that it would definitely be something I would do. So guilty, definitely, of making sure that my kids are in a good place. And even though it would be out of my control, I probably would be texting and being a little bit helicopter as well. So, you know, it can be really distracting and it can create a lot of pressure for applicants during their preparation. So here are some coping mechanisms or some boundary work that you can do with spouses, significant others. Maybe it's your boss who has invested in your prep and is really hoping that you pass because they need you. Or maybe it's your parents even that are just really on you to see how the prep is going, and they're communicating with you a lot and it is impacting your prep. So the first thing you want to do is you want to kindly ask them to stop in a nice way. So you say something like, "Mom, Dad, you know, wife, husband, I really appreciate your support. I love you so much. Your support means so much to me. But right now I'm really, you know, I'm getting into February soon. The bar is coming up in a little bit. I'm going to be limiting communication on text and the phone. So if you don't hear back from me right away, just know it's nothing to do with you, but I am going to be really focusing on getting this done. So thank you so much for the check-ins, but if we could just limit them a little bit, I'm going to be really in my zone right now." So hopefully that works. But as we all know, when we try and create those boundaries, a lot of times that doesn't work. So we have to go to the next level. And the next level is being a little bit more straightforward and saying something like, "If we could please limit the check-ins to me checking in with you, because, you know, I'm finding that I'm really stressed out right now. And although, again, you want to really acknowledge the effort that they're putting in, I appreciate the support you're giving me and the love, but the text 10 times a day, which some of my students are getting from their loved ones, is quite distracting, and I'm having a hard time focusing when those are coming in." So being a little bit more specific with the boundary language. And if you've never done this kind of work, there's plenty of articles online and things that I will be covering in a podcast that I'm going to be launching in the next couple weeks. We're definitely going to be talking about boundary work. It is so important, not only in life, but in career, in law school, and bar exam prep for sure. Now, the third thing is, if the loved one is really not getting the hint, that's where you potentially need to create some space. So significant space. Now, I don't want to get, well, I might get some feedback here, and that's okay. I want your feedback, but sometimes you have no choice. Now, if you're living with the person, this is going to be a little bit harder, but it's something like, "I really just feel like right now I don't want too many check-ins. If there's something I need for the bar exam or support, I will reach out to you directly." So it's something that is really creating a very clear line of, "Don't communicate with me anymore." And that's only if it's really stressing you out. Sometimes the support is helpful and there are very healthy relationships that can really help you during this prep. I know for me, during the preparation, my husband would bring me food or coffee, and he's not a big check-in type of person. So it relaxed me a lot. I mean, sometimes it was more like, "Where are you? Why aren't you checking in with me?" And I was a bit of a nag about it because I wanted that emotional support at the end of a long study day. But not everybody is like that. Some people just want to be left completely alone. So you have to do what works for you, and don't be scared to create that boundary for yourself during your bar preparation or any other time in your life also. And you always want to be kind. You don't want to be mean. There's no reason to create argument for any reason. Not only is that not healthy, but it's not going to be anything good for you or for your state of mind. And the key is to let the person know that you love them. And, you know, they're always going to love you too. Whoever supports you is always going to love you. They're not going to be disappointed in you. They may be upset if you don't get this done, which hopefully you will. Of course, that's the ultimate goal. But creating boundaries should not create too much friction with people that can handle them. And if it is a scenario again where the person cannot handle it and they're coming at you and fighting with you, that's really where you want to create some very clear lines of, no, we can't do this right now. We can, you know, come back to this after the bar, but right now I'm going to take some space. So if you have any feedback on creating boundaries, if you've done them in your life, if you are studying for the bar exam and dealing with something similar, I want to hear from you. Put it in the comments. Other than that, I hope this was helpful.